Hey drone nerds, it's Matt. I'm sitting down today with Matt from Freefly Systems. Welcome, Matt. How are you?
I'm doing great. Great to be on. Thanks so much for having me.
Yeah, thank you for your time. So first off, just tell us a little bit about yourself and about Freefly Systems.
Sure. So my name is Matt Eisenbarger. I've been with Freefly Systems for a little over 2 years now. Got my start in the drone world over a decade ago. Helped start DJI's program back in the day, and then was at AeroVironment, working on DoD type of opportunities mostly, and most recently joined Freefly Systems as CRO. So just found the perfect intersection here. Of this kind of enterprise focused team that's going after all of these awesome use cases that drones are so good at. Freefly has been around for over 13 years, dominated the cinema industry from the beginning, and really grew up out of mom's garage, all self-funded, and just built tangent products as they found problems and needed to solve them for customers. So Freefly, has grown incredibly well just organically, and it's just this really awesome place to be and really fun place to work, not to mention all the fun technology products that we build.
Okay, and we're going to talk about the Astro today. Give me a little background about the Astro and what some of its use cases.
Absolutely. So Freefly has been designing and manufacturing drones for a long time now. So Astro is really the sixth generation drone of their drone product line. So it's sitting over here, over my right shoulder. You can actually see Alta X sitting over this shoulder here. So Alta X can carry 35 pounds of payload, but it's a much larger aircraft. It's really kind of this flying pickup truck, if you will. But we took all those learnings over those previous generations and built that into our latest, more compact industrial drone called Astro. And so it has a quick release interchangeable payload that we call Smart Dovetail. So you can see a whole bunch of different payloads right here that are on our Smart Dovetail. And again, that just makes it easy to, with the push of one button, you plug and play a whole wide range of different payloads. So we really focused on ease of use for those folks that needed to switch out their mission from day to day and had different projects. We've always been known for high reliability, and that's really due to our testing and the support that we put behind all of our products.
Who's the primary consumer for the Astro platform?
Really kind of any enterprise or commercial application. So you'll see a lot of folks in surveying and mapping, inspection, construction applications, high resolution cameras, LIDARs, anything to do with remote sensing is often target industry for us. So agriculture with multi-spectral, mining, hyperspectral sensors. We have folks tracking endangered wildlife with wildlife tracking antennas. We sell a mapping payload, 61 megapixel, very high resolution mapping payload. And Astro has RTK and PPK baked in, so you can get extremely highly accurate and precise maps and inspections. We also sell Weirs Pro thermal plus zoom payload for public safety and inspection applications. Again, just on our Smart Dovetail here. So all these payloads that you see behind me just slide into that same interface, and it makes it really easy for any of our customers to swap between these various payloads and projects that they have on any particular day. And we've also just come out with our new hand controller, ground station controller that we call Pilot Pro. So it's got a Samsung Android-based tablet built in with all of your traditional position, altitude, and manual flight controls, as well as a dedicated kill switch that's a double throw for added safety. And then we've introduced a new flight mode as well that we call slow mode. And when you push this button, it turns on all these knobs and dials on the top, and it allows you to make very minute, precise adjustments to both the vertical and horizontal drone speed or gimbal speed, making it, again, really easy to inspect assets, capture those cinematic footage, whatever it is that you might be doing. It gives you total control and a lot of customability over what you're doing and on any particular application. And then the backsides also got all sorts of rockers, knobs, triggers, and what have you to control your aircraft that way, with all sorts of IO here, USB-C, Ethernet. We've got modular radios on board. So depending on which country you're in and which frequencies are your regulators allow, you know, you can switch between different radio frequencies and different power levels, different ranges, et cetera. So it's really this kind of universal controller, not only to control Astro and Alta X, our two aircraft, but anyone else's drones or robotic platforms out there. We wanted this to be easy to integrate.
Really cool. Yeah, the controller, the amount of customization is pretty impressive. That's cool.
Yeah, you can totally map the buttons and knobs to whatever your preferences are. And it has internal runtime of about 6 hours. So those internal batteries are charging the Samsung tablet as well. So you're going to get 5 to 6 hours of runtime, you know, with full screen brightness and everything turned on, and charges in about an hour as well.
Cool. Let's talk about some of the payloads. What are some of the featured payloads for the different use cases you could put on there?
Yeah, so you can see right here, this is a Sony A7R4 that we wrap our gimbal, Freefly gimbal, around. And it really allows for a whole host of applications, primarily targeting surveying and mapping, as well as inspection applications. You can change out any of the common E-mount Sony lenses with any of the other lenses from any other companies who make E-mount lenses, and, you know, put a long focal length lens on there for inspection applications. And it ships with a 24 millimeter for mapping applications. So that payload alone covers a ton of different applications. The Weirus Pro, again, is another one that we sell directly on Smart Dovetail. So you can just pop that on there. And like I said before, it's got a 640 radiometric thermal core, as well as a 10 times optical zoom RGB camera there. So you can, you know, stand off from a very far distance, very safe distance away from your critical infrastructure, for example, and zoom in and take video and photos of that particular asset, but also switch over to thermal, you know, in the exact same flight and capture that data. So a lot of solar panel inspection, roof, facade inspection, public safety applications, things like that with that camera. And then over here, we have a host of different payloads. So this is a multi-spectral payload from Centera. And we don't sell any of these payloads directly, but because the interface, that Smart Dovetail interface that connects the payload to the drone, is an open source standard, we don't charge any licensing fees, or there's no cost for these payload manufacturers to integrate that into their payload. And so once they do that, they have the ability to sell their payload with our aircraft and anyone else's aircraft. And there's many other drone manufacturers that have also adopted that standard. So again, this is a multi-spectral payload from Centera for agricultural agronomy and field inspection. This is a 65 megapixel, extremely high resolution mapping camera. This is a dual EO IR thermal plus zoom camera for public safety. Here's a spotlight. Here's a really impressive LiDAR, again, on our Smart Dovetail, plus a camera down here, so you can do colorized point clouds. And then we actually just started a new partnership with HoverMap, or with Emisent, who creates the HoverMap. And HoverMap is a LiDAR that spins around 360 degrees, gives Astro complete obstacle avoidance, even in GPS denied scenarios. So you can fly Astro underground, you know, a mile underground in a mine with no GPS, no light, all sorts of dangerous things, you know, down there, and you know, wires hanging down and very inaccessible areas that you never would want to send a person. Astro can now fly and create incredibly high resolution 3D maps and models of those difficult, challenging environments. Our design philosophy is, you know, this thing is a flying pickup truck, if you will, and you can should be able to throw whatever you want in the back of it, and whatever the job is that day. You know, our aircraft lasts a really long time, and we test them extremely thoroughly and support them for a long time. So, as you know, it's very hard to keep up with all the new payloads, and there's all these companies constantly working on new iterations, the latest, greatest. So we want customers to use this Astro platform for a really long time and just upgrade or change their payloads out as they need them.
And what sets the Astro apart from some of its competitors?
It's really all the little things. So we have always focused on price to performance ratio. So not only is the performance as good or better than all the other options out there, but the price is also reasonable for that performance. And then we, again, take our testing and our everything to the extreme in terms of design philosophy and, you know, kind of overbuild and put robustness into every piece of the process. So, you know, we have over 100 activities that we do in kind of this six phase process during the design and development of any new product, test for thousands and thousands of hours before we ever release a product to the market or announce it. And then it's coupled with, you know, unlimited free support. And we want to make sure that these customers, you can come on site and get training here. But again, all of our documentation is online, and we encourage everyone to you know, read through those manuals and look through our tutorials, watch those videos that we post, and always happy to help support anything else that customers have questions on.
Okay. And what kind of maintenance, you know, once you have the drone, you guys have done lots of testing, you've already seen what wears out. What are some of the things that somebody can kind of look for and keep an eye on?
Yeah, we have a preventative maintenance schedule that we post in our wiki. Fortunately, these aircraft only have a few moving parts, and there's no oil or gas, you know, no oil changes or anything like that. And these electronic motors are just extremely robust again and lasts for a very, very long time. So besides kind of the common wear items, you know, a few of the fasteners around the props, and you know, sometimes people nick up their props on landing if they're landing in grass or some other challenging environment, rocks that get kicked up. But besides that, there's really not much to the maintenance program. You'll see it all, again, documented in our wiki. But you can also send your aircraft in, you know, every 1500 hours is kind of what we recommend. And send it in to us. We'll do a once over, make sure, you know, inspect everything, replace common wear items and send it back to you like new. So again, we really want these platforms to last a really long time and just upgrade your radios, your payloads, the software over time with new capabilities and features as you need them.
That's really cool. Besides your dovetail mount, is there any other unique accessories or anything like that?
So Astro is both RTK and PPK capable right out of the box. So there's a couple different ways to do that. You could buy our RTK ground station, which gives you extremely high accuracy right there on site. But Astro also has an LTE modem on board. So if you choose to, you could put a SIM card from Verizon, AT&T, you know, whoever, in there, just like your cell phone, and get real-time data connectivity, assuming there's, you know, cellular connectivity in the area that you're flying. And you can set up an RTK corrections network over the air. So if you have a local cores network or in-trip network, you can set that up. And without the need for an additional RTK ground station, you can pull those corrections over the air. And then on the PPK side of things, you could also bring your GNSS base station out there if you're doing some surveying and mapping, collect that data while you're flying Astro, and you pull the Rhinex final off there, inject that into our free PPK app. Again, it's just on our website. Anybody can download it. And then right there in the field, even you can correct your data after the flight using PPK. So those are some of the common surveying and mapping tools. We have all sorts of radio options, you know, spare parts and accessories. We have an optional FPV camera that just plugs in with USB-C into the bottom of Astro.
Yeah, a lot of transparency. I like how you guys put it all out there and let the people have access to everything they need, because, you know, with your product, you want to support them. And it's just really important. There's a lot that goes into it.
Absolutely. And we don't have a sales team, so we really value that efficiency. And we rely heavily on our partners like Drone Nerds and others to be that local support, that local sales, you know, assistance to help customers, guide them through that procurement process, do demos, get support, you know, and reach out for kind of that frontline defense. But again, Freefly is always here to help our partners out as well.
Cool. What's in the development phases with Freefly? What's on the horizon?
Yeah, so the latest thing we just launched last week was the Emisit hover map. And again, that's that LiDAR that spins around 360 degrees, and gives you complete autonomy with Astro. You can fly in GPS denied, completely dark spaces. We're seeing a lot of interest out of Department of Transportation who want to inspect the undersides of bridges or inside of tunnels, and mining and architectural groups and engineering groups who are doing construction and things like that in very challenging environments. The next thing that you'll see with Pilot Pro is more radios. So we'll have additional radio options that give you the ability to have NDAA compliant radios in various licensed and unlicensed spectrums. And it just gives you a lot of opportunity to use this aircraft and these systems in different places in the world with different regulatory environments.
Yeah, and the technology is changing so fast. It's really impressive how rapidly it's expanding. Where do you see the industry going in the near future?
Yeah, there's a lot of kind of different things that we're seeing. You know, remote ID has been one of the latest challenges to work through as the FAA has kind of pushed off deadlines and changed some of the format of it over time. But it's coming up now. We think it's actually going to stick this time. You know, and March 16th is the latest deadline that they proposed. So with Astro, it's really nice. The hardware is already on board all of these existing Astros out there. It's just a software update that will give you compliance and turn on your remote ID. And so I think, you know, that's kind of step one for a lot of these regulatory bodies to say, okay, now that we can track most of these aircraft and understand who they are, where they are, why they're doing what they're doing, then we can kind of push into some of these more advanced operations. And the FAA has put out a notice for proposed rulemaking around Part 108, which essentially is more like a driver's license for a car, where you'll kind of have to go through some additional testing, but it gives you those advanced capabilities to fly beyond visual line of sight, and, you know, fly over people at night, you know, all these things that you've traditionally had to get waivers for. I think you're just going to start seeing more of that baked in to these kind of at the pilot level, at the operator level, to give you that capability, as well as some of the aircraft manufacturers doing additional certifications.
Cool. And last question is a fun one. What do you love about Drone Nerds?
I love that Drone Nerds has just been a great partner for us. They make it easy to work with them. They keep things in stock. They have a talented technical team that can answer those hard questions if it's not something that's kind of just your generic part number. If you need a special integration, if you need a little extra help adding this widget or that thing, we really relied on Drone Nerds to help with some of those special projects as well. So from, you know, sales and having things in stock to you know, support from before and after and through the sale, they've really just been a great partner for us that way.
Well, thank you for your time today and for sitting down with me. I really appreciate it.
Absolutely. It's been great chatting with you.
Yeah. And viewers, if you have any questions, you can leave those down in the comments and we'll get back to you, or give us a call here at Drone Nerds. So thank you, Matt, for your time. And I look forward to talking to you soon.
Thanks so much. Take care.
All right. Take care. Bye.